Hello guys, welcome back to the Civil Engineering YouTube channel. Please subscribe our channel for daily Civil Engineering videos. Today our lecture is about the SAP2000 commercial software. SAP2000 is a commercial software used in many industries for the analysis and design of structures. It may be for the frame structure, for the steel frame structure, for the retaining wall, for the beams. You can use this software to analyze your any type of structure member. So it's very useful to use this software in order to get your desired work. So and today in this lecture I will do some example that how we draw how we model and how we analyze the simply supported beam. As you can see here, the simply supported beam having a length of 10 meter and the load of 5 kN acting at the center of this beam. So we have to draw its shear force and bending moment diagram through the SAP2000 software, that how we analyze this beam with the help of SAP2000. So let's start. So first of all, we should change its unit. Like as you can see here, our diagram beam has the unit of kilonewton and meter. So first of all, we should change our unit according to the drawings. Like there are different types of the units you can see here, kips inches, kips foot, and kilonewton. So we will click here the kilonewton meter, because our beam was in kilonewton and meter, the force was in kilonewton and the length was in meter. So that's why I changed my unit to the kilonewton meter. Now to start the model, first of all I will click on the file and the new model, and then I will select. So this window appears in which I would select one of the option. So this unit is can be seen as kilonewton to meter, so it's okay. And the grid only, I will choose the grid only, so to draw my beam on this option. You can also choose the beam as directly, you just enter the span length and the number of spans you want, but I prefer to use the grid only method. So our beam in the x direction, you can see here, the beam has two ends, a simply supported beam. One is a hinge support and one is the roll support on the other end. So we have 2 points only for this beam. So I can put in x direction we have 2 grid line, and the y direction we have nothing. So I can write it 1. Similarly in the z direction I can also write it 1. While these are not so important, grid lines are more important to use correctly. So now in my beam length is 10 meters, so I will modify it here. So this is the 3D view on the right side, you can see here. I will close this 3D view so for now. Now this is my this is not my beam, but this is my grid line view, right? So with the help of this pen I can move my beam, move my whole frame. So now to define the beam of 8 length, I will double click on this. So the grid system edit data comes on the desktop, on the screen you can see, where you can see here the length of the beam is shown here is 6 meter from A to B, right? So I can, you can put here, you can click on the exit view, so I can see here clearly that this is the AB, right? So the AB point is, now again click on this beam, the distance between the AB is 6 meter, you can see here. So I will write 10 meter, right? Because my beam length was 10 meter, and in the y direction there is nothing because the beam is a single line element. So okay, so this is my beam of length 10 meter now. But this is not the beam, this is just the grid line. If I click on the grid line, if I click the height grid, all grid lines, okay, so my beam will disappear. So actually this is not the beam, but this is the grid line. So again click on the right of the mouse, so edit grid data, modify, and uncheck this one, so my grid system will again appear. Now I want to define my beam here, that this is my actual beam. So define this beam, first of all I will define the material properties, the geometry of the beam, and then I will be able to draw my actual beam. So now going to the define, first of all I will define the material. These are these are the default values, so I will delete this material, no need of this material, I just have to add the concrete of 5000 psi, right? And I also to replace this rebar reinforcement, not steel bar, okay? It should be rebar of grade 14. Let's suppose I'm using grade 14, 5000 psi as concrete strength. Okay, now I will define the section properties. Frame beam comes under the section of under the category of frame section. So in new property, we want concrete beam, rectangular beam, and I'm just giving the name here is beam, and the concrete strength is 5000. Okay, and this is the dimension of the beam. Let's my beam depth is 0.4 meter and my beam width is 0.2 meter. So and concrete reinforcement I can place here with Maya. It's okay. My steel grade is 40. Okay, okay. Longitudinal bars as well as the stirrups, you can see the ties, both are in 40. Here I click the beam because I have to design the beam, not the column. So the cover is 60 millimeter, you can see here, or 0.06 meter. So I will change it 0.04. also here is also 0.04. so because the cover concrete usually used is 0.04 in 4 top and bottom, but it depends on the design, right? Let's is I assume is to be used is 0.04. okay, and then okay, so this is my beam, right? We create the beam as well. Now to draw the beam, view two option. One is this one, draw frame cable element. So this is beam, you can see here. Okay, so I just put here on the beam and just cross it to up to this point. So this is my beam. One is this way to draw the beam, and now I can undo it. And the other method of drawing beam quickly is the quick draw frame element. Just click on this and select the beam. Yes, okay, and just click here. So I will directly the beam will directly be drawn. So now this is my beam, but this is beam without the supports. So now to draw the to add the supports to the beam, I can click here and I can assign the joint restraint is the hinge support at the left side of the beam, right? As you can see here, the left side view hinge support and the right side view roller support. So here again, the left end, I will assign my roller support. Okay, this is the roller support. So now this is my beam. I can say yes, this is my beam, simply supported beam, roller hinge support. And now I can double click on this and now hide grid lines. So I will be remains with the beam. You can see here now that the grid lines are hide, but our beam is still there. So now this is our actual beam having length of 10 meter, simply supported beam. Now to define the loads on this beam, first of all, I will define the load pattern. That the one is the dead load, and I want to place some live load on this beam. It's 5 kN is given to us. So live load, and I can mention it here live, and this is safe moment multiplier is automatically zero because the SAP2000 will not calculate this by itself, but the dead load will calculate by itself. So yeah, a new pattern. So this is my live load. Okay, now to define the loading combinations, I want to draw the new load combination. I give it name of factored load, right? So the load combination is linear. Yeah, right, we are not going any seismic analysis, earthquake analysis. The dead load factor is should be 1.2. It depends on your standard, which standard you are following. Like I'm using now currently American Concrete Institute standard, so the dead load factor is 1.2 and the live load factor is 1.6. so adding these two, okay, so this is a factored, right? You can also modify later on that these are your dead and live load factored. So this is my factored load combination. Okay, so after this, defining the material, defining the section properties and defining the load, I can click on this beam and assign the beam and assign the load to this beam. So frame load and point load, because my load was only 5 kN acting at the center of the beam. It was live load, so kilonewton meter, it will be in kilonewton, right? And there's a gravity, yes, in the gravity direction. And also I will click on this absolute distance from N1. It shows that you are using absolute distance, and my loading distance will be 5 meters from the left end, and the load also acting is 5 kN. So add to existing load, right? But also there is nothing different and replace the existing load because there is no live load before on that, so it's okay. So this 5 kN load act now on this beam. As you can see here, completely I have modeled my beam. As I have shown here, this is a beam of length of 10 meter having load of 5 kN. So this is the complete modeling of beam in SAP2000. Now, one thing remains now to analyze it, how to draw their shear force and bending moment diagram, right? So I will start my analysis, but first I will save this file. So I will save this file here. So I will save this file by the lecture 1 on SAP2000. I will also upload more videos on the SAP2000 in coming lectures. So lecture 1, okay. Yes. So this is okay, and now I want to analyze this beam, run analysis. You can also put a 5 directly, and the model should not be run. It's okay, and the didn't live load, yeah, it should be run. So now we are running this problem. You should wait up to 5-10 seconds. So now this is the deflected shape of our beam. You can see here the load was acting at the mid, so the maximum deflection you can see here at the mid point, and also the bending moment would be maximum at the mid point. If I start here animation, this is the animation of this beam, and also we can show, we can see this beam in the 3D view. This is how it deflected, right? This is the exit view, how the beam deflected. So now I want to draw it to display its shear force and bending moment diagram. So go to the display option, and the shear force, show forces, stresses, and then joints. First of all, I want to know about the reaction forces due to the deflected load, not due to the live load, not due to the dead load. You can also choose, but I want to know about the deflected load reaction, support reactions. Okay, so these are my two support reactions. You can see each one is 15.31 kN. Support reactions, one is on the left side, one is in the right side due to the load acting at the center of the beam. But this reaction is not due only due to the live load. This reaction is also due to the calculation of the dead load of the beam, and also the affected dead load and live load, because I ate the combination load. So this reaction is not only due to the 5 kN, but due to the combination, the affected combination load acting on this beam. Now I want to know about the forces and frame cables, right? To know about the vector load again, and the shear force I want to find, and to know about the values of the shear force. You can see here the 15.31 is acting here on the left side, but the and also the 15.31 acting on the right side. But you can see here now this diagram is in opposite direction to that we draw usually in our notes, but the values are same, but SAP usually take it in opposite direction. So the maximum shear is 15.31 acting at the ends of the beam. Now to know about the bending moment, I can click on the moment 33. So okay, so this is my maximum moment due to the factor load acting at the center of the beam, 48.28. so this is my maximum bending moment, and we should design our beam according to that. So this was the method how to draw the shear force and bending moment, how to know about the shear force and bending moment of any, you can draw the shear force and bending moment of any beam given to you. Just first you have to model, you have to define your geometry properties, the material properties, the load combinations, which load combination you are using, and then analyze it. Simply find the shear force, find the bending moment, and you can get easily your required values. Hope you guys understand. In the next lecture, I will upload more videos regarding the slab column, slab design, column design, and the beam design as well. And so don't forget to subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you for watching my video.